Everybody makes errors. You do, I do, we all do. Messing things up is part of what makes us human. Software engineers are no different. In fact, a software engineer spends 80% of his or her time fixing and debugging problems that already exist in software they've already made. Unfortunately, this process is extremely time-consuming and expensive. That's why we've begun studying ways to take concepts used in the fields like cognitive psychology and integrate them into fields like software engineering. Software is literally everywhere. In your phone, in your laptop, in streetlights, in pagers, in ATMs, even in crockpots. All of this software has to be designed and built by humans. So, just like anything else humans are involved in, there's going to be problems. In computer terms, these problems are called faults. A fault could be a streetlight turning yellow then green instead of yellow then red. Or it could be something like the Snapchat filters swapping your face with the refrigerator or your cat. Faults are simply the noticeable problems that you see when using a product. Now, software has faults because humans make errors. Errors are the underlying mental mistakes that lead to faults. Errors are acts like forgetting, misreading, or simply not knowing what the software was supposed to do. These errors lead to faults in the final product. A fault would be a pager that doesn't ring, but the error would be forgetting to write down that the pager was supposed to ring in the first place. Dr. James Reason, a psychology professor at Oxford University, literally wrote the book on human error. It's fittingly titled Human Error. In his book, he delineates three different types of errors: slips, lapses, and mistakes. Slips happen when you just do something wrong, like putting milk into the cabinet instead of the refrigerator. Lapses are when you forget to do something, like going all the way to the store only to realize that you forgot your wallet or purse at home. Lastly, mistakes are failures in planning. A mistake would be driving to the store only to find out that the store was closed. You didn't do anything wrong per se. Your plan was just doomed to fail from the beginning. The store was closed even before you left. Your plan to go to the store was already ruined before you even decided to go. That's a mistake. In our research, we hypothesize that slips, lapses, and mistakes are just as relevant in the field of software engineering as any other field. Software designers and inspectors are just as vulnerable to these errors as the rest of us are. The problem is, not much has been done in the field of software engineering to correct for these problems. Other fields, like aviation and medicine, have all developed ways to limit human error on some level. Things like checklists, extra examinations, cause and effect diagrams, interrelational diagrams, current reality trees, things that work well in those fields but don't really work well in software engineering. This is mainly because they're very complicated and very confusing to look at and don't really help at all. I mean, would you want to look at these things while you're proofreading someone's paper? So our research is trying to develop simpler and more effective strategies and tools for inspectors to use to find errors. We're doing this first by trying to figure out whether or not people can actually think through the mind of someone else. This is because most companies hire inspectors to read through the software requirements to look for faults. Think of it like a software version of proofreading, but instead of looking for comma splices or run-on sentences, they're looking for faults. These inspectors don't really have a set way of proofreading though, and that's what we're trying to help design. But first, we need to figure out the second part of our study. Whether or not people can think through the mind of someone else, but also determine whether a fault they find was caused by an error in the planning stage or the execution stage. Essentially, we need to discern if people can read through the mind of the software writer and abstract any errors they may have made from the faults that the reader finds. It's like proofreading a friend's essay and then trying to figure out whether or not that misspelled word you found was caused by a slip, a lapse, or a mistake. Developing some sort of tool to make the inspection process quicker could drastically influence the rate at which technology gets designed and built. Fortunately for us regular consumers, that means more advanced technology in our hands quicker, and also much cheaper. With companies not needing to spend so much money on finding and fixing faults, it may be possible that those savings could be seen by the consumer. This could result in more and more technology being available to more and more people. All of this could be a long ways away, but the small steps we're taking now could end up leading us to those goals. So think about how much software you use in your daily life. There's a lot more than you may think. I hope you enjoyed this video, and don't be afraid to tell me if I got anything wrong. I am only human.